Hello viewer, my name is Alabi Benga Rafael. I will be teaching the topic properties of coordinate subject mathematics. The objective of these topics are to identify angles subtended by chords in a circle, to identify angles subtended at the equal chord and derive the rider, solve problems on angles subtended by chords in a circle. Introduction to chord. A chord of a circle is a line segment joining any two points on a circumference. So this is an example here. This is a line which is called a chord. Why? Because it is joining two points on the circumference. This is the first point that is joining, and this is the second point that is joining on the circumference. A diameter is a chord which passes through the center of the circle. This is an example of a diameter. It is a line, but it's called a diameter, not a chord, because it passes through the center of the circle. Can you see? This is the center of the circle, so this line passes through the center of the circle. A chord which is not a diameter divides the circumference into two arcs of different sizes, a major arc and a minor arc. This is an example here. This is a chord that divide this circumference or this circle into two different sizes. The first one, which is the larger part, is called the major arc, and the smaller part is called the minor arc. The chord also divide the circle into two segments of different sizes. It is known as a major segment and a minor segment. This is the chord that divide this circle into two different segment, which is this is the minor segment, this is the major segment. In figure 1.3, this is the figure we are talking about. PQR are points on the circumference of a circle. PQR are points on the circumference of a circle. APP, this is APP. Note one thing, wherever you see the cap, it means that that's the angle we are talking about. When they say APB, it means the cap is on P. It means we are talking about this angle here. AQB, AQB. So it means we are talking about this angle here, and we are talking about this triangle AQB. ARB, ARB. We are talking about triangle ARB, and we are talking about the angle here. Are angles subtended at the circumference by the chord AB, by the chord AB, or by the minor arc AB? APB, AQB, ARB are all angles in the same major segments APQRB. All these triangles or all these shapes are inside the major segments. None of them is inside the minor segments. So that is what they are trying to explain here. Similarly, in figure 1.4, this the figure we are talking about, this diagram here, AXB, AXB, and AYB, AYB are angles subtended by the chord AB or by the major arc AB in the minor segment. So which is all these shapes here are inside the minor segment. Midpoint of a chord. A straight line drawn from the center of a circle to bisect a chord, which is not a diameter, is at right angle to the chord. This is a straight line. This is the center O. This is the center of the circle. The center of the circle is labeled O. A line is drawn from the center of the circle to bisect a chord. This is a chord AB. So it bisects this chord into two equal halves. So since this line is from the center of the circle to bisect the chord, then it is at right angle to the chord, which is it bisect this chord. And can you see that we can have two different right angles here, which is this a right angle, this another right angle.
Given a circle with center O and chord AB, OM such that AM equals to BM, Note, AMO equals to BMO equals to 90 degree. AMO is equals to BMO, which is the angle here, and is equal to the angle here, which is equals to 90 degree. So let's prove this equation here. So construction, join OA and OB. Prove with the lettering in figure 1.5. OA equals to OB. OA is equals to OB, which is equals to radii. Radii is the plural of radius. AM equals to MB. The distance between AM is the same thing with the distance between BM. OM equals to OM. These two right angle triangle are sharing this line OM. So that's why we have OM for this one is equals to OM for this one here. Therefore, triangle AMO equals to BMO. Triangle AMO is equals to triangle BMO. Therefore, AMO equals to BMO. But AMO plus BMO equals to 180 degree. AMO plus BMO equals to 180 degree, which is this is angle on a straight line. The two of them are angle on a straight line. So therefore, AMO equals to BMO, which equals to 180 divided by 2, which equals to 90 degree. The following rules are also true. A straight line drawn from the center of the circle perpendicular to the chord bisects the chord. This is a straight line drawn from the center of the chord. Drawn from the center of the circle, it's come to bisect the chord. The perpendicular bisector of a chord of a circle passes through the center of the circle. The bisector of a chord must surely pass through the center of the circle. As you can see, this line bisects this chord here. So it's for it to bisect this chord, it must come from the center of the circle or passes through the center of the circle. Okay, this is an exercise. So let's try this exercise out. A chord of a circle of 12 centimeter long. This is the chord of this circle. This chord is 12 centimeter long. So when they say it's 12 centimeter long, if we are to divide it into two equal half, then this place, the half, one of the half will be 6 centimeter, the other half will be 6 centimeter. The radius is 10 centimeter. From the example or from the theorem we proved last, it shows that this place is the radius and this place too is the radius. So this place is 10 centimeter. Likewise, this place is also 10 centimeter. Calculate the distance of the midpoint of the chord from the center of the circle. From the center of the circle, calculate the midpoint of the chord. So which is we have to calculate this line here. From figure 1.6, this is the figure. O is the center of the circle. This O here is the center of the circle, which is this point here. AB equals to 12 centimeter. From this place is equals to 12 centimeter. AO equals to 10 centimeter. From this place is equals to 10 centimeter. M is the midpoint of AM equals to MB. M is the midpoint of the center O. So triangle. So AM is the same thing as MB because they are 6 centimeter. In triangle AMO, triangle AMO, which is this angle here, AO square equals to AM square plus MO square. So now we are using Pythagoras theorem to solve this question. We have this angle, we have this side here, we have this side here. So we are calculating this side here. And Pythagoras theorem says that the longest side, which is the hypotenuse, which is AO square, is equals to AM square plus MO square. So that's Pythagoras theorem that we are using here. So we are now going to, what we are looking for is MO square. So we are going to making MO square the subject of formula. So from this equation, if we make MO square the subject of formula, this is what we have. So MO square equals to, what's AO? AO is equals to 10 centimeter minus, what's AM? Was AM is equals to 6 centimeter. So this is 10 squared minus 6 squared. MO squared is equals to 100 minus 36. MO squared equals to 64. Then MO is equals to root of 64, which is equals to 8 centimeter. Therefore, the midpoint of the chord is 8 centimeter from the center of the circle. So this is the summary of properties of chord. A chord of a circle is a line segment joining any two points on a circumference. A diameter is a chord which passes through the center of the circle. A chord which is not a diameter divides the circumference into two arcs of different sizes, a major arc and minor arc. The chord also divides the circle into two segments of different sizes. It is known as major segment and a minor segment. Midpoint of a chord. A straight line drawn from the center of a circle to bisect a chord, which is not a diameter, is at right angle to the chord. A straight line drawn from the center of the circle perpendicular to a chord bisects the chord. The perpendicular bisector of a chord of a circle passes through the center of the circle. So all these ones that is here, we've explained it before in the previous pages. So these are some exercises for you to try on your own. It's very simple. So when you are through with this exercise, you can send your inquiries and answers to this Gmail here, gmo.smith@31st.ng. Thank you. That will be all for now.